Recently, the International Cricket Council announced the awards of the decade celebrating the standout performances during the last 10 years. The ICC invited votes from experts and the general public. 90% of the votes were pulled from the experts of the game, while the fans accounted for the remaining 10%. Surprisingly, Ravichandran Ashwin was not nominated for the ICC Test Player of the Decade, an honor ultimately awarded to Stephen Smith. Given Smith's dominance with the bat, he is definitely deserving of the honor. However, Ashwin's performances merited a nomination. The fact that Yasir Shah was nominated ahead of Ashwin has come as a big surprise. And in this video, we briefly try to understand what if Ravichandran Ashwin deserved to be nominated, and can a case be made for Ashwin as the premier test player over the last 10 years ahead of Steve Smith. The man from South India has been a great asset for the Indian cricket team since his debut. It would not be wrong to say he is as important to the bowling attack as a Virat Kohli is to the Indian batting lineup in Test cricket. In the 73 matches Ashwin has played in this decade, he has taken 375 wickets at an average of 25 and also some handy lower middle order runs with the bat that is close to 2400 runs with an average of 28. The only two players who were nominated under the ICC Player of the Decade for the Test cricket who could have given a run for the money to Steve Smith were James Anderson and Ranganathan, who have been legends of their own ball game and fittingly have great average with the ball and good number of 5 wicket hauls too. But one man who really made an impact this decade and a tough competitor to Steve Smith was a tall off-spinner from Chennai, Ravichandran Ashwin. Since Steve Smith made his debut, on 21 occasions, an Australian member made it to the ICC Test Team of the Year. And out of those 21 occasions, Steve Smith has made it on 4 occasions. However, having made his debut a year later than Smith, Ashwin was among the 13 Indian members who made it to the ICC Test Team of the Year and featuring 4 times out of those 13 times compared to 4 occasions of 21 occasions from Steve Smith. Staying with the ICC team and rankings, one thing which Steve achieved and was a factor to which influence for his award and not many modern players have achieved was the rating of 947 points in 2017, which was the highest ever after Sir Don Bradman. However, the feat of touching the 900 plus points in the ICC ratings is considered as an achievement in itself, which only Virat Kohli and Sunil Gavaskar have achieved for India in the batting department. Whereas the feat of 900 plus points has been achieved by 5 Australian players in the Australian cricket. Among the bowlers, R Ashwin is the only bowler to cross 900 points barrier for India with 904 points in 2016. This is a testament to the impact Ravichandran Ashwin has had for India in the previous decade. Furthermore, 23 of Ashwin's 27 5 wicket hauls have resulted in an Indian victory, with India losing the match only on one occasion. Conversely, only 18 of Steve's 26 hundreds have resulted in an Australian victory, a slight edge Ashwin holds here if the 5 wicket hauls were compared to the centuries. Now let's tell you something more interesting. Ashwin has won 7 Man of the Series awards until now, which is by far the highest by any Indian. He was successful in picking up his first Man of the Series award in the year 2011, and there has been no looking back for him since then, whereas Steve Smith has 4 Man of the Series awards. When we compare the series won by these two players when they win the Man of the Series award, 7 out of 7 series win for Ashwin and 3 out of 4 wins for Steve Smith when they get the Man of the Series award. In the series defining impact, Ashwin holds an edge over the former Australian captain here. A factor where the premier batsman from Australia had an edge over the finger spinner from India was in the ICC Player of the Year awards. Steve was selected twice in 2015 and 17 as ICC Test Player of the Year, whereas Ashwin was selected once only in 2016. The stats of Ashwin's batting are not really bad for an all-rounder. R Ashwin was comfortably placed as the number one all-rounder on few occasions in the decade, which hardly got noticed. Well, the favoritism towards batsmen in cricket is always to think of. Although the nominations for the ICC Test Player of the Decade had 3 bowlers out of the 7 nominations, did ICC miss to pick the one that really mattered? Of course, we are not denying the fact that Steve Smith is a great player, but the impact Ashwin had was surely something to consider, if not the man winning the Player of the Decade award.
Check our other whiteboard style cricket videos backed by deep research. Kindly subscribe to our channel and help us grow. Thank you.